My name is Hannah, and this is my beauty budget. Hello, and welcome to my video with the soothing ambient noise of ambulances, fire trucks, and a building being built in downtown Los Angeles. My bangs were misbehaving today in a serious way, so I decided to just go ahead and pin them back. I hope it's not too traumatic for you to be seeing my forehead in all its glory. I think it's definitely time for me to wash my hair. This video is super exciting for two reasons. First of all, the topic of the video. I'm so excited to show you how I have been storing and organizing my clothes in our new space. I am going to film a whole apartment tour when the loft is done, but we're still putting on a few finishing touches. And in the meantime, I've really been enjoying the way that my closet is here. It's not really a closet because I don't have an actual enclosed closet, but I feel like that's what makes it intriguing. And a lot of you guys have expressed curiosity about how we store and organize stuff in this open concept space. And the second exciting thing is that this video has a sponsor. And that sponsor is the meal kit delivery service Home Chef. Home Chef sent me a box of meals a couple of weeks ago, and they're sponsoring me to just tell you guys about my experience with the box at the beginning of this video, and to give you guys a coupon code for a discount if you sign up with my link in the description box down below. Now, I was excited when Home Chef contacted me about a sponsored video because I have been getting very, very curious about how a meal delivery service might fit in to our life. I cook a lot. And Joe and I go grocery shopping like clockwork every week, but it seems like meal kit delivery services are a hot topic lately, and I've been reading a lot about the potential benefits of them. So I've been growing curiouser and curiouser about what the actual experience of cooking from and eating from a meal kit delivery box would be like. So I agreed to try it, and I can tell you that my experience with Home Chef was seamless. The website was easy to use, everything was super clear, I was able to order meals that fit with our dietary preferences, which is a really big deal for me. That's kind of like a deal breaker. If I hadn't been able to do that, I wouldn't have agreed to do the sponsorship. Everything arrived on time. And in case you're curious, or in case it matters, the general dietary preferences for our household of two people are lots of animal protein, no sugar and no artificial sweetener, and minimal processed food. The majority of what we eat is made from whole, fresh ingredients, so minimal preservatives, short, pronounceable ingredients lists on things that are canned or bottled, and the meals that we ordered from Home Chef fit the bill just fine. So all of that was good. However, the absolute best and most wonderful thing about ordering from Home Chef, which I didn't really fully comprehend, I think, until we actually did it, was that it removed a significant amount of labor from our week. We usually go grocery shopping together on Sunday morning, but 2 weekends ago, which was the weekend before we got the box, I flew to Portland. Sadie, why are you squeaking? Sadie has something to say. 2 weekends ago, I flew to Portland for a tango marathon. I danced all weekend. I flew back on Monday. And so we missed our grocery trip. And usually when that happens, it throws the entire week off. So we might try to scramble and go grocery shopping after work one day early in the week, but then I still have to make the dinner, and so then we end up eating really late that day, and it's not ideal, and it throws us all off, and inevitably we end up having to buy lunch once or twice that week and often go out for dinner once or twice that week. In short, if we miss our shopping trip, which does happen not infrequently, it always ends up being a disorganized, expensive, and less healthy food week for us. But this time, when I got home from my first day back at work after my trip, the Home Chef box was waiting, and I just popped it open and cooked a healthy dinner in a timely manner, as usual. It went beautifully, and it was really yummy. I'll insert some pictures here. I ordered double servings of both meals so that we could have leftovers, because we usually eat leftovers for lunch the day after I cook, and we sometimes even extend it to eating leftovers for dinner the next day. It was such a huge relief to have the groceries delivered and the meal already planned. It absolutely saved our week. I'm super grateful to Home Chef for giving me the chance to try them out, and if your interest has piqued, all of the relevant links will be down below. I believe the code is for $20 off of each box for your first 4 boxes. All right, moving on to the meat of the introduction to the video. We will be getting into the meat of the video shortly because I don't have that much to say by way of introducing my closet. You will see it. But I did want to talk about kind of where I think I fall on the spectrum of minimalism and maximalism, because historically I've been kind of a maximalist, and I feel like aesthetically, in a way, I'm kind of a maximalist. Like, I'm really drawn to feather boas and color and texture and drag queens and big fluffy eyebrows and bold lips and mixed prints and statement jewelry. Like, that, I'm not a minimalist, because when we say minimalist, we tend to think of the aesthetic of minimalism, like white walls, clean lines, wood floors. That's just not me. I love lushness. But I am leaning more into what is, compared to my historical way of dealing with stuff, a minimalist way of curating my stuff. I don't even know if I can claim that, but I hope you guys know what I'm trying to say. Basically, I like the feeling in this new space that I can see everything that I have and that there's not too much of it. So my dresses are not the dresses of a minimalist. They are lush, they're rich, they're textural, they're colorful, they're dramatic, but I only have, I think I have something like 7 day dresses and 7 formal dresses. So that's 14 or 15 of them. And they're all there in the line and I can see them all. And each one has its own hanger and its own place and its own place in my vision and its own place in my heart. And in that way, I feel like I'm moving more towards a minimalist philosophy when it comes to my wardrobe. So I've been trying to think how to describe this state of being, of having a minimalist curation of maximalist belongings, and I've landed on the label lush minimalism. I'm probably not the first person to think of that, although maybe I am. I feel like there have been several labels or attempts at labeling this thing floating around. I've read an article recently about, what was it? Quiet maximalism. That's what it was. I read an article about the trend of quiet maximalism in home decor, which is an attempt to describe essentially the same thing. I don't know if I'm a quiet maximalist or a lush minimalist, but I'm going with lush minimalism as the guiding principle, not only for my closet, but I feel like for our home in general. I don't know if this will make sense, but you are about to see what I am trying to talk about, and hopefully it will resonate with you. You will have to let me know what you think. In any case, let's go ahead and get into the meat of the video. All right, guys, so I've backed up as far as I can to get everything that's relevant in frame. There is some natural light coming in, but I don't think it's enough, so I turned on those overhead lights. I hope the color balance is decent. So this is the part of our space that we use as a bedroom. It's totally not finished. We're gonna paint, I think. That right there on the other side is the one closet in the entire apartment, and it's Joe's clothes closet. And that's why I'm using this open space here as my closet. So really it's just this space right here. That wire shelving there on the right is a little bit multi-use because we have some of our extra blankets there and we're storing our electric typewriter down there at the bottom. But for the most part, this little area is mine. And then here on the left, this is where we'll start actually. Here on the left, we have some built-in shelving. We're using it for our record player, which is right here in the middle. And then some beautiful little things on top. And that's where the little fairy is living, you guys. I know many of you have asked about her. And then down here on the bottom of these built-in shelves, I've commandeered a shelf for my most attractive bags, the ones that sort of hold their own and stand up by themselves on a shelf. So this is the one from Polen Paris that my sister gave me for my birthday. This is my Teddy Blake bag here in the middle. And then here on the end is a little bag by Miele Bianco. And I like having them here. This is also a good place to put some of the art that we couldn't fit on our walls because we moved from an apartment that had like 3 times more wall space than this one does. In one of these boxes is just some spare lighting. I think there's some like Christmas lights in there. This box has some of Joe's papers in it. This box has our workout equipment in it. It's got like hand weights and straps and stuff like that that we use almost every day in the apartment. But this box down here has sweaters in it. For the first time in several years, I decided to store some of my clothes. Until now, I've been using the Marie Kondo method of having everything within sight, no matter the season, and within reach. But in this space, I have relatively little space and it's all on display. So I chose to free up some of these shelves right here on the right by putting the sweaters, the heaviest sweaters, the ones that I'm definitely not using right now, into that little box down there. All right, let's move over into the actual closet area. So here on the left, and you may remember this little piece of furniture if you saw my closet clean out that I did in our old apartment. This is from IKEA as well. And I don't think it's that attractive. I mean, it's definitely not that attractive. It's the kind of thing that should go inside of a closet. It's great for storage, but wouldn't it be ideal, the old Hannah says to me in the back of my mind, wouldn't it be ideal if we could get some gorgeous vintage chest of drawers or something romantic, something aesthetic to go in this spot and hold my things? The old Hannah would be on a frantic search for something much more beautiful to sit in this spot and serve this purpose. But after my no-buy year and all of the transformations that I'm working on going through right now, I am perfectly happy to just be happy with this out in the open. So here on the top, I have my perfumes. Some of you have expressed interest in my perfume collection, and there it is right there. I'm not going to go through it right now, but that's about the measure of the thing right there. And I enjoy having a little spot to put my phone, my keys, and my sunglasses because those are the things that I misplace the most frequently. In this new space, I got this little plate. I actually took it from our kitchen cabinets and I put it here on top of here. And every time I come home, I pop these three things onto this plate and I haven't misplaced or lost track of any of the three of them at all since we moved to this space. The other thing that I have on top here is a tarot deck that wasn't getting that much use before, and having it laid out in this new space, it's getting a lot of use and I'm really enjoying it. I think it's called the Collective Tarot. That's the spine of the book. So it's called the Collective Tarot, and it's a deck of tarot cards that was created by a radical queer collective in Oregon. And I purchased it, they did a Kickstarter campaign several years ago to fund the creation and printing of this deck, and I purchased it through that Kickstarter, and I absolutely love it. I keep this incredibly beautiful stone sitting on top of the book. And it's been really cool to have it out here because what happens is that from time to time, Joe will draw a card and from time to time, I will draw a card. And then we'll just read about it in the little book and feel our feelings and think our thoughts. And we've both been enjoying it quite a lot. It's not like we discuss it extensively and neither of us actually reads tarot cards technically. Neither of us is trained in the art of tarot, but it's just something that I set up since we moved to the new space and it's been delightful. So this is the most recent card that I drew, The World. I feel like it's perfect for me. This is from an Etsy seller and I bought it several years ago. It's a photograph. It's a photographic print and I love it. And I love having it in a place that's pretty prominent so that I can see it every day and it casts its magic out over my clothing and my experience of getting dressed in the morning. Now I am using this top drawer for jewelry and deodorant. You may remember if you saw my closet clean out that I used to display my jewelry in a much more aesthetic way. So I had a black velvet earrings board and a black velvet bar on which I had hanging all of my necklaces and bracelets. And it looked better, but it was less practical. I was less likely to wear my earrings because it took a long time to unfasten them from that board. It looks messier, but it works better and it feels better to me. It feels more lush. There's kind of a sense of abundance, but I can see everything that I own just fine. So I've actually been really, really pleased with my decision to start storing my earrings and my other jewelry this way. And then in this second drawer, I've just been putting the less nice handbags that I sometimes use. This third drawer here is all of my bras and underwear. It's a total mess. I think that my bras and underwear could use some decluttering actually right now, but this is just always how it's gonna be. I think from time to time, I've tried to fold and like line up my bras and underwear the way that Marie Kondo suggests, and I just can't maintain it. I always end up with it like this, everything thrown in and tangled together. But I find, similar to the jewelry, it doesn't prevent me from knowing what I have, seeing what I have. It doesn't frustrate me. Down here, I am keeping things a little bit better lined up with the Marie Kondo method. These are my tanks and tees. Same down here. These are my leggings and pants that aren't hanging on hangers. And then here in the bottom, I have my tango clothes and a couple of pieces of workout gear. So when we moved to this space and we realized that we were going to have an open concept closet for me, we decided to commandeer one of the beautiful industrial clothing racks that we use in the Poema studio, which is the little studio that Joe and I rent for our small clothing business. When I started hanging my clothes on it, though, I realized that I had four dresses. Well, I guess it's three dresses and a jumpsuit that were too long. And I didn't like them dragging on the floor. So I hung this little hook up on the wall, quite high, quite close to the ceiling, so that I could hang my longer pieces from it and they wouldn't be touching the floor. This is a dress by Yumi Kim, a designer I really like. This dress is from Moschino, Love Moschino. I bought it at Nordstrom Rack ages ago. And then there's a Reformation dress back there, a black Reformation dress, and a white jumpsuit. Here on the clothing rack, I'll go through it. I'll go through it quickly. This is really my main coat. Then there's this wrap sweater from All Saints. This is by COS. It's kind of a long jersey knit style blazer. This is by Isabel Marant, Etoile Isabel Marant. And it's like a soft felt blazer. Love that piece. I got this at a Buffalo Exchange in Portland for $25. It was an incredible steal. And then this is a haute hippie piece. It's a vest with a shearling collar. So those are my five ways of staying warm in various levels of inclement weather. I'll just go through my blouses one by one, but I'm not gonna necessarily tell you the brand of each one. This is just like a white cotton blouse, some tank top style blouses. This is the piece by Lisa Q that I've been wearing in a couple of videos lately. I absolutely love the silhouette of that top. This is too small for me, actually. I need to sell it. It's my only beautiful mustard piece in my wardrobe, and every time I put it on, it's just a little bit too tight. It's from a designer consignment shop as well. An empty hanger. I try not to have too many empty hangers, but I like to have a few mixed in here just so I don't feel like I'm gonna go to hang something. There's not gonna be one. I was previously made uncomfortable by empty hangers. I felt like I was doing it wrong if I had empty hangers, but now I like having a couple of them mixed in. I'm just trying to take a deep breath and let go of having everything be absolutely perfect at all times and just let it be a little bit more functional. Here's a little silk cami. These are some Diane von Furstenberg blouses. This is a Marnie blouse I got from Yuke's years ago. All my DVF blouses are basically from consignment shops. This is a haute hippie sequined top that's also from Nordstrom Rack. I think this is COS. It was a gift. This is another Lisa Q piece. Absolutely stunning. Silk blouse by Equipment, DVF, a linen piece by Eileen Fisher. I've worn that in a bunch of videos lately. Diane von Furstenberg. This is a kind of cotton silk blouse by a kind of obscure designer, Paula Calais, maybe a smaller designer. I really love this piece. It gets more wrinkly every time I wash it, and I really like how it looks. Another black linen. Here's another empty hanger. Here are my more formal pants. This is faux leather track pants from Zara. High-waisted wool trousers. White linen pants. Couple more pairs. These are more drapey cotton pants. But I guess there's just, these are kind of more track pants. So it's sort of a mix of casual and formal, but those are the pants that I have hanging here. Here's another empty hanger. And then here are all of my dresses, barring the three that are hanging up on the wall, the long ones. This is a jersey knit column dress. This is a jersey knit reformation dress with a plunging neckline. The casual and the fancy ones are all kind of mixed in. So this is a more formal dress. These are all more formal. This is a dress I made, actually. It's my Poema design for a tango dress, except that I made it extra long. It's a maxi. Another casual dress. And casual dress, and then this is the more formal dress. This is one of my favorite pieces, actually. It's vintage, and I purchased it when I was working as an actress in Belgium, which is a weird moment from the history of Hannah that I've still never talked about on my channel. But I really like having it here at the front because the entrance to the house is from this direction, and I like looking at this gorgeous, strange, glimmery vintage piece when I first enter the house every day. And that brings us to the final little section of my wardrobe, which is the second to the top shelf on this rack of shelves right here. That's my laundry basket, which I previously talked about in a check-in. It's currently full of dirty laundry. How attractive. Sweaters, sweater dresses, and scarves. And these are the ones that I feel like are still in rotation even though the weather is warming up. I've got this wool scarf, this is a silk scarf, this is a silk scarf, and this is a lightweight cotton scarf. Those are basically my four scarves right there. And they're mingled in with the sweaters because I've been wearing them. I've been attempting to wear my silk scarves more often, actually, because they're so precious. This is actually an Hermes scarf, this one down here. It's so precious and so beautiful, and I'm sort of reluctant to wear it because I'm worried that I'm going to ruin it, and I just don't want to live my life that way. I want to wear my beautiful things. So sweater dresses, sweaters, and scarves are all mixed in here. I'm taking you back through so you can get the full picture once again. Oh, one more thing I did forget to say. Here on the other side of the shelving is a beautiful weekend bag that I purchased when I was studying tango in Buenos Aires in Argentina. And inside that bag, I'm storing the rest of my handbags. So I have two slouchy Marc Jacobs bags and I have one leather backpack. I use the leather backpack a lot, especially when I'm traveling. The two slouchy Marc Jacobs bags I haven't been using, and the fact that I was able to pack them away in this bag and just leave them sitting there without ever worrying about them is telling me that I think it might be time to declutter them. So I am probably going to get them cleaned professionally and then sell them, maybe in my Poshmark shop. But for now, they're just living their best lives inside of that bag, and I find that I reach for one of these structured bags whenever I want to carry a nicer bag, and I reach for one of my totes or that slouchy work bag that I'm storing inside that wire drawer whenever I want to carry a more casual bag. And for me, those are enough. And the other thing I didn't talk about are shoes, because all of our shoes are down there in the entryway. And this is a part of the house that we truly haven't finished yet. Like, this is actually the main part that we still need to put a weekend of work into. I must say that sometimes when I come home, I come over here and I take these three items out of my bag and I put them here. And then I put my bag away either in that drawer or on the shelf right here. And then I often put whichever pair of shoes I'm wearing in that little spot right there. There doesn't happen to be a pair of shoes there right now because I left them in the entryway when I came in today. But that little slightly awkward empty spot often has a pair of shoes thrown into it. And I think that that's all. I think that's everything. What do you think, Sadie? Thank you so much for watching this little tour of my open concept closet. I want to thank Home Chef again for sponsoring the beginning portion of this video, and to remind you guys that if you'd like to know more about Home Chef, you can click through my link in the description box down below. I hope you enjoyed ogling all of my belongings, and I hope that you are remembering to take extra good care of yourself this week so that you can be the most effective version of yourself as you do your work in the world.